You can do external rotation, just holding by your hand, have a partner here on the tricep, and just by the look of the pictures, you can just figure out. Basically what we're trying to do is get good scapular movement on the rib cage. Okay, so we've got scapula that for a lot of times people are like stuck to their back, are depressed, right? They don't come up, they can't get into upward scapular rotation, so they get run into problems with they lose a lot of their reach, number one. And number two, they lose a lot of this, because if your labrum is laying forward like this, all tries to come up, there's a blockage there. So until you get that all the way back, as Rory was saying, you've lost mobility right away. And scapula, on God, every guy and girl that I've tested, they don't move, they just sit there. They're very immobile, right? So getting those moving. So guys, when you're trying to think about, you're gonna have a desire to move it with your arm, right? Because that's what you're just used to. What you want to do is initiate your movement with your shoulder.
Alex. So as Jason's working there, I want you to just watch Alex's shoulder as he moves, right? So we want to have that scapula moving. Is the scapula really moving that much? It's kind of fixed in one position. His arm isn't moving. So if you were watching Alex at the beginning, he's getting like my height off the floor, arm swinging through. Is his scapula following that motion of the shoulder? How quickly is his shoulder going to start to break down with that wear and tear, right? So now what I'm going to have him do is he's going to start with the shoulder depressed, and as he reaches up, I want him to extend that scapula out, reach up, so we're extending right through, depress the shoulder down in that top position, and then relax down. So we can work on, like, if I move here first with no movement, and then I lift, now I'm getting the scapula through. So I'm teaching him how to move at that top position, and now I just integrate both movements together at the same time, and then I limit them together. So I can actually get the shoulder blade moving first and then move the arm, right? So you can work it in different ways. And that's how you teach patterning, right? I'm gonna do this first, then I'm gonna do this first, next, and then I'm gonna do this and this, and then I'm gonna do this, and this, and move, and all that other fun stuff that you can add on top. Right, so it's just getting the shoulder moving through. You do that with your athlete prior to the pepper. I'm not a volleyball guy, forgive me my term. If you get them doing that right before, have them try serving afterwards. You'll notice that they move so much more gracefully, and they get a lot more pop on the ball. Okay, so now you're gonna do